Hello! In this lecture, we'll cover the very important universal law of gravitation. Isaac Newton discovered the basic law that describes how gravity worked. He elegantly used mathematics to describe the force of gravity in his universal law of gravitation. Three simple statements summarize gravity. First, every mass attracts every other mass. Second, that attraction is directly proportional to the product of the masses. And third, the attraction is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between their centers. Mathematically, all three statements can be combined into a single equation. It says the force of gravity, Fg, is equal to the product of the masses of two objects, m1 and m2, divided by the distance between them squared. The symbol g is a constant called the gravitational constant. Gravity is an inverse square law. The force decreases with the square of the distance. Move the objects twice as far away, and the force decreases by 4. Move them 3 times as far away, and the force decreases by 9. By the time Newton published his Principia in 1687, Kepler's laws of planetary motion had already been known and tested for about 70 years. Kepler's laws were so successful that there was little doubt about their validity. However, there was debate about why they worked so well. Newton resolved the debate by showing that Kepler's laws are consequences of the laws of motion, and in particular, the universal law of gravitation. With the aid of mathematics and calculus, Newton showed that Kepler's laws applied to all orbiting objects, not just planets. Also, he found ellipses are not the only possible orbital paths. Ellipses, which include circles, are the only possible shapes for bound orbits, but objects can also follow unbound orbits. These are paths that bring an object close to another object just once. Some comets, for example, follow unbound orbits. They come in from afar just once, loop around the sun, and then never return. We usually think of one object orbiting another object, like a planet orbiting the sun, but Newton showed that two objects attracted by gravity actually both orbit around their common center of mass, or the point at which the two objects would balance if they were somehow connected. When one object is more massive than the other, the center of mass lies closer to the more massive object. The idea that objects orbit their common center of mass holds even for the sun and planets. It's just that the sun is so much more massive that the center of mass between the sun and any planets lies inside the sun. Left undisturbed, planets and everything else would keep the same orbits forever and ever. Orbits cannot change spontaneously, but they can change through exchanges of energy. One way that two objects can exchange orbital energy is through a gravitational encounter, in which they pass near enough so each can feel the effects of the other's gravity. This figure shows a comet headed toward the sun on an unbound orbit. The comet's close passage by Jupiter allows the comet and Jupiter to exchange energy. Spacecraft engineers use this idea in reverse. For example, on its way to Pluto, the New Horizons spacecraft was deliberately sent past Jupiter on a path that allowed it to gain energy at Jupiter's expense. This extra orbital energy boosted the spacecraft's speed. Without the boost, it would have needed an extra 4 years to reach Pluto. Friction can also cause objects to lose orbital energy. For satellites orbiting Earth, if the orbit is low, the satellite will experience drag from Earth's thin atmosphere. This drag gradually will cause the satellite to lose orbital energy until it finally plummets towards Earth. If we give a spacecraft enough orbital energy, it may end up in an unbound orbit that allows it to escape Earth completely. Although it would probably make more sense to say that the spacecraft achieves escape energy, we instead say that it achieves escape velocity. escape velocity does not depend on the mass of the escaping object, but it does depend on whether you start from the surface or from someplace high above the surface. Because gravity weakens with distance, it takes less energy and a lower velocity to escape from a point high above the Earth's surface. Again, we covered a lot, but that's it. Take a break, get a cappuccino, you certainly deserve it, and I will talk to you again soon.